Good morning, I'm Morgan Shutters. This is your MyHighPlains.com news update. Use extreme caution this morning when you're driving. Blowing snow and slick roads make for dangerous driving conditions around the area. Several wrecks were reported yesterday, including this one involving a flipped 18-wheeler on I-40. Now, the system is bringing heavy snow, slick roads. Estimates for accumulating snow have been dropping during the last few days, but that doesn't change how slick the roads have become. The Amarillo Police Department received more than 170 traffic-related calls yesterday due to the dangerous driving conditions. The blowing snow is increasing the amount of ice on the streets and highways. Though TxDOT is working to melt the ice and clear it up, they still need your cooperation to reduce your speed. Now, with all these wrecks, the demand for blood goes up, and the Coffey Memorial Blood Center could really use your help during the coming days. The road conditions forced them to cancel 3 blood drives, so they need to make up more than 60 units of blood and are in dire need of O negative and O positive blood types. Well, an outdoor propane heater being used inside causes a 2-alarm fire. It happened yesterday just after 2 in the morning on the 1200 block of Northwest 12th. It took 8 units, just about an hour and a half, to get the house fire under control. There were no injuries, but Red Cross was called to help out the victims. In other news this morning, a teenager is indicted for stabbing a young boy in October. 18-year-old Jabari Weatherton is charged with aggravated assault with a deadly weapon. Police say Weatherton stabbed the boy near Irene and Northeast 24th after they got into a fight on October 30th. The boy was taken to the hospital with critical stab wounds. Weatherton later turned himself in. In other news this morning, investigators still don't know the cause of death for a Fritch man whose body was found at his home Friday, but his death is still being treated as suspicious. Police say the autopsy found no foul play, so it's what investigators didn't find that makes it suspicious. The body of 57-year-old Larry Ewing King was found inside this home Friday afternoon. The Carson County Sheriff says the preliminary autopsy indicated no trauma, but the medical examiner did confirm what investigators found, a single needle mark on King's arm. Some Amarillo surgeons get hands-on training for the latest gallbladder surgeries. Doctors and staff at BSA learned about the SILS procedure yesterday. The innovative technique removes the gallbladder by going through the belly button. There's minimal scarring as compared to the 4 incisions they would normally make in surgeries past. Well, Amarillo attorney and Republican Marty Raleigh is expected to make an announcement this morning that he'll be running for the District 15 seat on the Texas State Board of Education. The district was newly redrawn and includes 77 West Texas, High Plains, and Panhandle counties. He'll make his announcement at the Caldwell Banker Center Realtor's office this morning in Amarillo. The Amarillo Chamber of Commerce Women's Council announces the Businesswoman of the Year. Congratulations to Frida Powell. The award is based on community service and business success. Despite the snow, it was announced at a luncheon yesterday afternoon. Well, if your kids are ages 6 to 18, they could catch some hoops with Air Police. Clovis PD started a program, Cops and Kids Basketball, last year after the chief wanted to figure out how to get kids off the couch doing something interactive. The kids get to take on the Boys in Blue for 10 minutes at Clovis High School's gym. Officers say the event, it's free, and it's a great chance to have the cops see that the kids can get to know them very well. All right, well, in other news this morning, we do have more on MyHighPlains.com. You can get the news live streaming there. This has been your MyHighPlains.com news update.